In this tutorial, we are going to learn and test this VL53L1X time of flight laser sensor with range of 4 meter. This module is offered in this shape and color on AliExpress, eBay, and also it is offered in this shape. Let me go further at 30 centimeters. These modules are sold on AliExpress. I purchased one for $9.39 with few dollars of shipping. And the other module was also sold around $9.28 with $4 or $5 shipping. I received them about in a month. New from ST Semiconductor. They use I2C communication. Two wires in both cases. Here we have GPIO, this is the interrupt pin, and this is X shut, this is to shut it down. In some cases you want to shut this down and only turn it on when you need it to measure, but for our application continuously we will use it, so we will use VN 3.3 or up to 5 volts ground. And then SD and SCL, these two are for I2C communication. We will leave these two off. I'm gonna go through this in the datasheet, explain what they do, but without this, it can be used. And here in this module, they put those two pins on the other side. And we have VCC here and ground here, SD and SCL. And XChat and interrupt are put on this side, so you know that you're not making mistake. We have a voltage regulator here that when you inject 5 volts, you will get 3.3 volts for the module. So you can connect it to 3.3 or to 5 volts. Chip, this is the frequency is 50 hertz, which means you can measure up to 50 times a second, which is very fast. So the distance, the range can be set up to 4 meter, but it has three modes, medium, long, and short. Depending on which one we want to use in terms of accuracy, you can select different range, and we're going to just test it. In this video, I'm just going to display the value on the serial monitor. In the VL53L0X, I've created a video showing how to change the I2C address with some methods, but in this one, they've created a function with the library so you can easily change the I2C address. Because if you want this one to have separate address in terms of connecting with multiple I2C devices. This is the VL53L1X laser sensor. Here is the actual module. The size is 4.9 by 2.5 by 1.56. So this is 4.9 millimeter, 2.5 and 1.56 millimeter. It is an invisible laser of 490 nanometer wavelength of class 1. Let's have a look at the datasheet for VL53-1X. As they call it, a long distance time of flight sensor. And here's a block diagram or the pins, ground, SDA, SCL, and AVDD. These are the pins that we are using. We're not using this GPIO and XChat, these two extra pins. On the module, we have only this ground, XChat, and GPIO. It uses SPAD, single photon avalanche diode, receiving array. And the range is 400 centimeter and the frequency is 50 hertz, which means 50 times a second it can measure. And the distance that it measures varies depending on the setting that you have. It has a mode, distance mode. We can set it as short, medium, and long. And at short, it measures up to 136 centimeter in the dark, 290 for the medium, and 360 centimeter in the long. And the maximum distance in the strong ambient light, other lights that are disturbing it, the range will be reduced significantly. And in terms of timing budget or timing that it allows, it can go between 20 milliseconds to 1000 milliseconds or 1 second per measurement. That determines the frequency. And As you can see, if you go with 20 milliseconds in the minimum timing budget, that will be for short distance mode, 33 will be for all distance mode, and 14 millisecond budget allows maximum distance of 4. So if you want to measure 4 meter, we have to set it at this value. Depending on your application, sometimes when the measurement is not needed, you can shut this down using the X shut pin here, and it has been defined here. When you connect it to low, it will be like this. The power goes on, it goes in the standby mode until the X shut is high. So that is when you connect it to low. But if you connect it high, or if you do not connect it, this is how it behaves. When the power is off, the X shut is also off. When you turn it on, X shut automatically goes high without even connecting it. So the device will boot immediately. The module comes with a user manual. That was a data sheet. This is the user manual, and it will explain how to use it. I will provide you the link for this if you want to have a look at it. When the package arrives, they put a piece of plastic, make sure to remove it, otherwise it will affect the measurement. Length of the module is 23.9 millimeters or 0.94 inch. The width is 10.4 millimeters or 0.41 inch. Depth of the module or thickness is 4 millimeters or 0.15 inch. Width of this is 12 millimeters. Length is 16 millimeters. Depth is 3 millimeters. If you're concerned with weight, with the pins, it's 1.1 gram. 0.9 grams for the small one. When you receive the module, it is shipped like this with a pin header. You have to solder it, or if you purchase this module the same way, you have to break this and connect 4 pieces here, and if you need the interrupt, connect the 2 in here. Otherwise, you can use just this side. I'm inserting the pins from the bottom because I want the face to be free without wires on this side. I'm just holding it with one hand, with one finger, and then feeding the solder only on one pin. Once this holds it, then go to the next side. Now your finger is free. And continue the rest. Let me now explain the wiring. The code explanation and the wiring diagram for this is available as part of my Arduino course at Udemy. The link to my course at Udemy is below this video. VN is connected here via this black wire to 5 volts. Ground is connected using this brown wire to the ground. And here we have SCL, the red is connected to A5. SDA is connected to A4. These 2 pins are I2C communication pin. And also you can connect it to SDA and SCL here as well at this spot. I will provide you the link. This is the Adafruit library for VL53. I click and download it and save it in my download folder somewhere. You see SparkFun. Then click on Sketch, Include Library, add the zip library. From here, point it to where you have downloaded. I have downloaded into my download folder. And here is SparkFun VL53 L1X. Click and open. Then close Arduino, all instances, and reopen it. On File, Examples, and at the bottom you see SparkFun VL53 L1X, and click and open Read Distance. So all the components is supposed to be included with this library. This include.wire is for I2C communication, and this is for the device. If you're connecting it to these two pins, pin 2 or 3, XSHAT or an interrupt, this is the GPIO1, and distance sensor. We are initializing, creating an instance of this class, and we call it distance sensor. Inside the setup, wire.begin initializes the I2C communication. This is initializing the serial monitor. This is just a text. And here is how we can set the distance. If you want to measure long distance, distance sensor, this is the object, dot, and then set distance mode long. This will be for long distance measurement. Otherwise, comment this, and then use this one, set distance mode short. So this way you can set the mode inside the setup. There's no library to set this at the medium. And then inside the loop, this is starting the range sensing. And then to measure, we say distance sensor dot get distance as an integer. We are getting it here. And then after that, we are stopping. So this is holding now the distance and in millimeter. And here, serial.print will print this text, because this is inside that double quotation, and that distance as a variable will be printed immediately after that. And then here they're getting the distance, multiplying it by this factor to convert it to inch, and then this distance in inch divided by 12 to make it feet, and in case if you need those values, and print ln will create a new line. So one, this line, this line, and immediately after that this value, and with a little tab, this is backslash t mean tab character, extra space, and then this is a new line, and the loop will continuously read this code and measure the distance. And by the way, I've set this to short distance measurement. Now let me demonstrate it. I've set this to display the distance in millimeter and also distance in inch with two decimal places. Here is the module. I've attached it to this box. I'm just putting a weight here of hard drive to hold it for me. This is exactly at the zero. The sensor is exactly at the zero. And let's put this at 20 centimeter. Now this is at 20 centimeter. And as you can see, we are reading exactly 20 centimeter, or 200 or 201. It's just 1 millimeter off, and it is fluctuating. Let's see how close this can measure. I'm going 10 centimeter. As you can see, as we got closer, we are getting 4 or 5 centimeter off. Let me go further at 30 centimeter. Now it's 90 or 80, 290. So 10 millimeter is 1 centimeter off when you measure the distance at 30 centimeter inch side, so you can see it. Let me put it at 9 inch. You see 8.86 in terms of inch. Let's see at 6 inch. think Finch, it is very accurate. And by the way, I've set this to short distance measurement. Now I'm exactly at 12 inch. And we're reading 11.5, half inch difference. This portion, I've used it, I've prepared this from library. Now if I upload that, it will also tell you the SPAD value. So this measurement is with this amount, number of rays that it has, and it measures. And now I'm pointing this to a far distance in the hallway. 3.7 or 3.8, that's 370 centimeter. Let me point it further, what happens? Now this is being pointed. I've uploaded the code, the same, now it's the red module, I'm pointing it to the computer screen, 400 millimeter, pointing it to the wall further away. So we are reading 3 meters, and let me point it to the further away on the wall. Let me turn the lights off and see how it affects the measurement. It's around 290. The distance changes when the amount of the ambient changed. You keep all this in mind when you're using it in some critical applications. I will have separate video explaining and testing it under different conditions with playing with different codes, and the result will be presented as video for my patrons at patreon.com. The link to my Patreon account is below this video as well. There is some variation in measurement. I've compensated with 20 millimeter, and it was responding properly in certain distance. Again, when I changed the distance, it didn't show the exact value, and the measurement varied by about 15 to 20 millimeters. So that's, if you're doing some precise measurement, that will affect your measurement, so keep that in mind. Or some offset based on the environment, the ambient light, the environment that is affecting it, especially infrared or sunlight, will have a lot of infrared and it will affect this. So keep that. Thank you for watching. This was how to use this VL53L1X module. If you like this video and learn something, please thumb up, as this will help my video in the search algorithm of YouTube. That I'm putting it exactly at 15. This is 150. And as you can see, we are reading very exact value because there is some variation here between the distance and the space of this module, the thickness of the board, the thickness of this.